goal attack for the Aussies, Gretel Tippett, and a goal defense for South Africa, Sam-Marie Pidiel. This for the centers for Australia, Ash Basil, and for South Africa, Laura Lee Christians. Goal defense for Australia, Kate Simon, and goal attack for South Africa, Malika Hofstalzen. The goalkeeper for Australia is Sam Coleman. And for South Africa, the goal shooter is Bianca Rona.
Gets more theatrical, more theatrical as the day goes on. So both teams now out on court. Let's bring you up to speed with the power plays. Australia, well, they will have their power play in the second, and it'll be South Africa's PP in the third. Kath Cox, a good matchup in the middle, Brazel and Lauren Lee Christians.
A really good matchup, two incredible athletes to watch. You wouldn't think there was a serious game at Netball about to start after those weapons on court, would you?
Absolutely not. There's your umpires, bottom of screen. So game 13 about to get underway. And South Africa, as we mentioned, just the one win so far. Heading to the left of your screen. Marijke Holzhausen. Oh, quick ball between the two shooters. And they score early. Good, strong start.
Yeah, good, strong start. And they're not too worried about starting with the long shots, are they? They just want to get some points on the board early.
So Brazel works backwards. And Gretel Tippett being very good this tournament. Stanton, Kath Cox wants some long shots from her.
We'd love some long shots from her. Tippett's been great right here in this range. The two-pointer.
Oh, you've just put the mick on it. I could tell that. Not to worry. How good defensively has Gretel Tippett been?
She's been fantastic for them, hasn't she? She's so valuable out there at goal attack. Just the tips and touches. I think she's in the top 10 for deflections at the moment, which is quite impressive.
So the captain, Christians in the middle, and Brazel reads that too well.
Absolutely all over it, Ash Brazel.
Okay, goal defense. Where are you, Ash?
So Tippett lines up for the first two of the game. Beautiful shot from Gretel Tippett.
Well, look at that. Fraz just came flying from absolutely nowhere. I'd love to see when we get back to Suncorp Super Netball, Gretel Tippett still backing herself to take those shots that she's become so comfortable with.
Agree. Holzhausen swings to Christians. Nice drive from Rode on the baseline. And an easy one under the post for South Africa.
Style of game, it's so important to have the support from the back on the centre passes. Kate Shimon flying down to help out on that one.
Big fan of Mawini, the goalkeeper for South Africa. Absolutely, there she's again contesting, steps in, Tippett. And the contact has been called. Norma Plummer would have done a tremendous amount of work with Pumza Mawini.
Look at that lane, that's what I was talking about in the opener. Just so good, so what a shot that is, Stanton.
Well, that pleases Captain Kate Maloney. So Australia now out 4-2. And again, nice hold. Dianca Rode back out to Holzhausen. Goes for two. Well, Kate Shimon, I've been waiting all weekend for a little deflection off the shots. Hello.
She normally gets those fairly early on in any sort of tournament or game, doesn't she? She's taken a while, but she's got one.
He has Stanton to return the favour at the other end. Oh, not to beat.
Interested to keep an eye to in the background, Kate Maloney, Captain Kate Maloney. Had a knee in the previous game. She's doing a little bit more extra warm-up on the side, so I hope she's okay for this one.
So, there she is. I reckon the knee looks heavily strapped, but that will not stop the captain. She'll be on court in no time.
Keep the elbow in the two.
So the 2 points for Holzhausen. Oh, gee, not enough for breakfast this morning. So Sam Pullman in goalkeeper, debuting at this tournament. I had a bit of a chat to her earlier. She's absolutely loving Fast Five in the atmosphere.
Win, lose or draw, it's hard not to enjoy it, isn't it?
Oh, no. Don't take yourself so seriously. That's the motto. So a nice two-pointer to level the score. Early in this first quarter.
Kate Maloney's entered the game. such seamless rotations, aren't they, to get the players on. You barely notice it.
What a terrific rule that is, rolling substitutions. Tegan Phillip. Struggled to find the post this tournament, hasn't she? The coaching staff said they just want to get her to find a little bit of confidence.
Moving off goal to Finn.
And there it is.
There it is. On cue, Tegan Phillip.
Spider's breaking, goal attack.
Nice drive out the back from Pinar. And again, Rode just offering some good position here. Holzhausen for the long one. Pullman strong in front for the rebound.
And as much as this is a game designed around the shooting and the extra points, defence makes such a difference. And you saw that with the Diamonds playing New Zealand. New Zealand just couldn't score yesterday. Shim and Clough and Pullman have been fantastic this tournament.
So Maloney continues to work the ball around. When she wants the shooters to shoot, she often says, put it up, put it up. Tegan Phillip goes for a second long. Oh, hello. Hello, Tegan Phillip.
Have you reverse jinxed someone? That's a first.
Don't underestimate the voice of Sue Gordian's capacity to turn someone's game from negative to positive.
We'll see. Again, Pullman, just that beautiful lead and tip on the ball. Australia haven't been the best in pickups and gains this tournament. Certainly made sure they had that one in the bag, though.
Oh, strong take from Tippett. Offloads Tegan Phillip. Three in a row from the two. Oh, not to be.
What were you saying before?
No, I don't know. Move on. Strong rebound.
Contact centre.
Another player that I reckon has had a bit of a shining. That lady there with ball in hand, Pinar from South Africa. Grown since first game yesterday to game 13 today.
I think you actually find that with most of the athletes because it's the kind of game that tactically is just evolving every time you play, isn't it?
Absolutely.
And the one.
Yep. So no rotations made from the shooting for South Africa so far, Kat, which is interesting. Usually we see that happen, but they've steadied their line.
Well, particularly with the likes of Stoltz on the bench, so whether or not they want to keep her and play her for the whole power play quarter.
Oh, Tippett to try and keep it in play. 2 seconds left on the clock. It'll fall short for the opportunity to shoot, but that's a good opening quarter for the Aussies. They'll go into the break leading by three against South Africa. So the words of the captain from Kate Maloney. Hey, are you impressed by that yellow uniform? It's pretty bright.
It is very bright. It makes it look so tan, doesn't it? Someone could have shared some of their fake tan with Tegan Phillips.
Oh, Catherine, you're not allowed to say that.
It's not all natural, surely.
Might help her
contact
in her shooting accuracy.
And the two.
So the power play quarter now for Australia. This will be four of Tegan.
Beautiful.
Tippett, nice start.
Off the hand, it does not look like it's going to go in. It's such a flat shot, but it just does, doesn't it?
So we watched the tactics of South Africa through this quarter. Just to, where possible, delay the ball. Oh, there's no delay in that. That was beautiful. Holzhausen.
And this is Oh, beautiful timing again, Shimon. But this is a tactic that South Africa's taken a lot. Get Holzhausen into the two-point range. Get Rode under the post. She misses the shot. We've got a beautiful rebound. Or not.
Yeah, so it'll be Australia's ball on throw-in. It is their power play quarter. They want to manoeuvre down and get their shooters lined up and ready to shoot. Clough with Shimon. Quick ball. Hadley. Wow, that's great movement for the Aussies. Stanton to finish.
Didn't look like it was going to go in. She rushed that from the moment she got it. No need to do that just because it's a power play.
So don't forget, all of the Fast 5 World Series can be streamed live, fast and data-free on the Netball Live app. Of course, don't forget the finals coming up after our big celebrity game this evening. It's late this afternoon. So plenty of action still to come on day two here at the Netball Fast 5 World Series. Oh, good pin-up. That's terrific stuff from the South African. And into attack they go. Don't worry too much about that scoreline at the moment. Australia, power play time. There's Holzhausen, the quick offload.
I love that they're just happy again, as I keep saying it, but it's really hard to get your head around in this style of play. Just, you can keep going for those ones under the post.
So Como now into the centre for South Africa. We've actually seen her rotate between circle, defence and in the middle. Very talented. Stan to Hadley, over the top. Oh, good take from Gretel Tippett. Again, gee, what a powerhouse under the post.
Unbelievable under the post, isn't it?
There's the coach, Stacey Marinkovic. I reckon the tactic in the power play has changed slightly for Australia. Have a couple of long, but Tippett's there. If we can't afford to waste, we don't want turnover. We need to score, even if it is only a little two-pointer.
Absolutely. Well, it's still 2 points, isn't
it? I agree. No, there's little Renski Stoll's been terrific, a crowd favourite. That is why we love the pocket rocket who can drop it.
And look at the poker face on her.
Renski Stoll's. Terrific stuff. Australia now through Phillip.
It's off. She called it early. Presence of mind to chase it up too. You can often get caught just watching those shots because they're the long ones. Got to remember to chase those rebounds.
Gee, it's rare we hear a goaler say it's on. Imagine how cocky that would be. It's on.
It's good.
It's good. So 16-8 the score. And I say South Africa are doing a decent job here.
They really are. Defensively, they're doing a great job at slowing it up too. But nice and patient in attack. They're going back if they need to. Just a mishandle.
Sarah Clough enjoying her first Fast 5 experience in goalkeeper for Australia. Hadley in the middle.
Great defence here, South Africa, clogging that middle channel. Australia not having any easy path.
Gee, Maddie Turner just working overtime here. There's her third effort to receive that ball. She's had three on the way down. Tippett into the pocket.
Contact, goal defence in the two. Goal defence, contact in the two.
So the contact call sets up Phillip. She offloads.
On the land,
gee, I tell you what, that was close 3 seconds.
Yeah, and that's the lean of Mawini. She's really just put that doubt in her head and she was going to pass that one off. Gretel Tippett's smart here, though. She's gone up and stood there in case there's a rebound opportunity to take the South African defenders out of it.
So, Christians. Nice offload. Charmaine Bard now on it, goal shooter. She's popped in a reasonable amount of those super shots for her side. They'll need that. Maloney over the top to Phillip. Out to Tippett. So they want four here, the Aussies, and they get it.
Such a smooth shot.
So 16 points they've scored in this power play quarter, the Aussies. Christians, Stoles. Oh, gee, look at that. You can hardly see Bard at all. Charmaine Bard needing to work a lot harder for the ball, and look what happens. The Aussies come away with it. Contact to South Africa. Tippett.
Contact, goal defense.
Oh, that would have tested Maloney.
So she'll go for another four. Same shot just as before. And she'll get another go at it, courtesy of the obstruction. Up, eye, over, and in. Gretel Tippett shying for Australia here at the Fast 5.
Oh, I want to see this continue next season.
Oh, the Firebirds will want that too. Stoltz working with Bard. And
contact goalkeeper.
I think Charmaine Bard needs to continue to get exposed here at international level. I think she struggles a little bit with the physicality. Stoltz goes long.
And again, look at the lean over the shot.
So the siren has gone, but it will be a penalty shot, so we'll have to sit tight here and wait. Just the one shot for Renski Stoles. Two-pointer.
Hold time.
Hang on.
That's intimidation, that's a caution.
Okay,
all
so it's
play.
Intimidation to Sarah Clough. Well, this is interesting, isn't it? Renski Stoles has three goes at it and can't make it. Doesn't matter. Australia leading dominantly here, 28-8. Still half of the game to come right after this. Well, it's party time here at Fast 5. Day two, the crowd, well, they are chock-a-block in this stadium. It's Australia taking on South Africa. A very dominant first half to the Aussies, 28-8. And we have Anne Sargent, who's got a very special guest with her down somewhere in the crowd. Anne, who have you got with you?
Yeah, thanks. So look who I found. Katie Thwaites enjoying a well-earned rest after a brilliant performance in Constellation Cup. You tried your hand at some Fast 5 netball. Are you enjoying it?
Absolutely enjoying it. It was this time last year I was out with some war paint on my face. So it was a really great experience and I'm loving the vibe here. It's awesome.
I shouldn't really say she's having a rest. She's actually working really important initiative in One Netball.
Yeah, the One Netball initiative is all about multicultural inclusion and diversity. So it's a great avenue for people to be able to get out and enjoy our awesome game of netball, reducing a lot of the barriers, you know, in people's lives. So it's great to empower young girls.
A super message and what a great ambassador on and off the court. I guess we better get back to the action, Sue.
How much do we love Caitlin Thwaites?
I know, honestly. She's just such a great team player and we saw that more than ever throughout the Constellation Cup. Sitting on the bench behind Caitlin Bassett when she got her opportunities, she was brilliant, but just knows her role and was completely supportive of the team, even from the bench that whole time.
So we move into the third quarter. Catherine Cox, Australia have just had their power play. They scored 20 points to 3. But the good news for South African fans, it is power play time for them, and they really need to make the most of it. The whistle blows, we are underway. And that is the lady I'm going to put the weight on the shoulders of, Renske Stoles.
She's got to get the ball, though, and she's doing it behind two very tall defenders in Shimon and Pullman.
So Charmaine Bard given the first opportunity for four. And it's not to be.
Well, the opportunity for them to get the rebounds is going to be what's important. They've got to take the long shots, but they've got to have someone there to back them up if they miss.
I was going to say, tactically, would you say to them, just go long or let's chip away and
no,
go short?
Not at all go long. It's not a percentage play. For me, your twos, yes, but I'd just get some two-pointers being inside the circle for a bit. They don't need to rush it. They don't need to go for the threes. If you're behind yourself behind in the fourth quarter, then give it a go.
Fair enough.
We thought Gretel Tippett had a good quarter that last one. You'd be right. 16 points in the power play, equal best from any individual, but actually from South Africa against Malawi, equals 16 points.
Wow. There you have it. So Gretel Tippett enjoying the short form, the fun form of the game, Fast 5. There she is, ball in hand. Stanton.
Oh, gee. I think she realised too how far away that was.
I took a deep breath. Well, she makes a good effort to try and rebound that.
Hope she didn't hear us then. We put her off.
Oh, the rest of the stadium heard us. They just went quiet as well when she went to take that shot. So, Mawini working the ball out through the back.
Advantage, goal attack.
Advantage
moving off.
Romé Dreyer in the centre now. There she's on the drive. Pullman defensively over Bard. Bard for four.
Oh, it's hard enough to shoot from there, let alone with the reach of a Sam Pullman over you.
Makes it tough. Well, if that was football, Ash Braz, you should have marked that. It's netball. So, Holzhausen on now. Stoles takes a break. The rolling subs continue for South Africa. Oh, quick offload. Bard, third shot from the pink.
And again, you can tell the defence is in their heads, can't you? It's just not that natural turn and put your shot up.
Kate Shimon, Stanton up the drive.
Goal attack, contact.
Well, had a few people just look at me on that call then. They don't like that.
Contact,
not to worry.
Count on Jono to do a few little interesting ones, can't you, along the way?
Well, it is Fast 5. Yeah. It's entitled to have a bit of fun. So, Pinar. Oh, good ball to Holzhausen.
Contact, yeah.
So impressed by Pinar. Yeah, big, big improvement from her.
Oh, Sam Pullman again. If that goes in.
It doesn't matter, though. That is a super shot.
Standing super shot. With Alina Pullman, that should be worth 20.
Gee, that was important for South Africa. Look at that score immediately. Pops them up to 14. I tell you what, another one of those, and they're sitting at 20. This gets interesting. Charmaine Bard.
Get over the shot.
Instruction two.
Too easy in contrast for the Flyers.
So Holzhausen You can just see Bard. She wants the ball out there. That's her range. Have a go, young lady. Oh! Well, when the confidence is up.
Yeah. Back yourself.
Absolutely.
Hit her again. Nearly pulled off a beauty.
Kath, we've said throughout the commentary, Bard was the second most prolific shooter as Stanton tries to do the same. Last year behind Maria Tutaier. So she certainly enjoys a super shot. And Tegan Phillips going to have a go. Confidence. Mawini, rebound. So the power play ticking away here. There's your shooting percentage. South Africa down at 41%. Holzhausen, she's going to take this.
That's a lot.
Oh, well, Bard's the long-range specialist. Oh, and the ball kept in play as Australia were trying to do a substitution. Kate Maloney was running off the court, realised she could have rebounded it. Doesn't matter, the ball back in the hands. Clough now at goal defence. Hadley on.
Use it, Australia. Contact, goal attack.
So the use it comes from the umpire. Australia need to ensure they are heading towards the goalpost, not wasting time.
It's a tough rule, though, isn't it? You're minus a wing attack, so it is a lot harder to get it down there straight away.
Goal defence, that's intimidation, that's a caution. Penalty pass in the two.
So a caution going to Como there from South Africa. Intimidation of the shot. Well, she wasn't intimidated by the rebound, straight into it. Defensive effort from Paige Hadley. Need to move here, South Africa. 45 on the clock. How good defensive pressure, Kat.
Yeah, Australia doing such a great job. Tegan Phillips so valuable out of goal attack and defence as well.
Well, the foot's over the line, so it'll only be a 2G. They're really toying with it here. So, oh, surely not!
No way! That was on the sideline.
I'm just looking around at the crowd. Surely not!
Interesting that Holzhausen's not taking those shots herself. She's capable of shooting from that sort of distance. Just toying with the ball way too much for the final seconds here.
Well, Stanton toyed with Tegan Phillip on that occasion and then took the shot herself. It's interesting, you wonder whether the confidence goes, Kath, to a particular player in Bard to take those long ones. Well, not the best of power play quarters for South Africa. They do trail. We've got 6 minutes of play left to go. The Aussies looking very good at 30-14. Fast5 action. Australia are in the driving seat here, looking very good in this game against South Africa. 30-14 the score. Both power plays now done. 6 minutes of play left to go. Kate Maloney steps into the middle, the captain for Australia. And she has been terrific to watch.
Well, South Africa won't be happy with their missed opportunity in that power play. That was their worst power play of the tournament with just the 6 points.
Rensi Stoll spent very little time during that power play. 6 minutes. Why?
On the court.
Yeah, why? She had 2 minutes on there only.
I don't know the answer to that.
Contact, all the tech.
Chat with the coach and get back to you. No, it does seem odd, though, doesn't it? Because she is one of their better long-range shooters. But they are two smalls. Here's then, if you leave them on together, they're two best shooters. And there's no lacking of height in the Aussie defence end as we see Turner nearly come out for a screamer.
So there's Stoles, who we're talking about, in the two-point shot. Oh. That's the lady I want on the court. She's the one that can score them some points. I'm astounded. So the Aussies now in control.
Contact, goal attack.
Maloney on the drive.
Both power plays done. Australia don't need to do anything too fancy here. They could almost go back to traditional netball.
And Phillip lines up for two, full short, Tippett. Well, that's been the theme when it falls short, how strong that lane is. Brittle Tippett has been under the post.
Great tournament. She's either bobbing them in from two-point range or she's there to clean up in the rebounding.
Bonus contact on the ball. Throw in.
Yeah, miscommunication there for the South Africans. Sam Pullman, Tippett. Gee, she's done a lot of work. Turner on the drive. Phillip out. So Gretel Tippett, for me, the star of the Aussie side, along Kate Maloney. Como now.
Oh, there she is. I spoke about her defensive efforts before. Tegan Phillip. Not the tallest out there, but boy, she's athletic.
Ash Brazel rolls onto the court. Now in the centre. Just trying to set the play up here, Australia. Tippett steps in. Well, that was just deliberate, wasn't it? Set play into the 2-point.
And there you go, a little roll reversal.
Oh. And the look away pass to Tippett. Needs to deliver.
Well, interesting that they're doing that. They really don't need to at this point. Decent margin. Just shoot your 1-pointers, get the game underway.
Christians and Souls.
Oh, good. Brazel.
Yeah, contest from Ashley Brazel.
Closing speed's incredible, isn't it?
Terrific. Good switch defensively, Turner and Pullman. Souls again, given the job. Even Ashley Brazel's trying to defend it. And South Africa will take that throw in. Deanka Road on there just to offer a little bit of height for South Africa under the post. Oh, clever.
Smart
play. Oh, then she doesn't want to shoot it.
Too close. I don't want to be under the post.
Catherine, did you ever do one of those in your life?
I would never do one of those.
And it's
complex. Renski Stoles. Well, she's got a little bit of everything, this young lady.
Oh, great rebound again.
Oh, she just stood there saying, Road, you get the rebound. I'll take the
one
shot.
One more time.
Well, Australia know they don't want her to have the ball. That's been a fascinating 1 minute of play to watch. Talk me through this trickster moment.
Well, smart move. Defenders standing away. Plenty of space to do it. Then she's realised, in this form of game, I don't want to be under the post. I'm going to get rid of this.
Oh, dear. Tegan Phillip.
Oh, Braz. A couple that she's fumbled over the sideline. Ash Brazel, sorry. Not something she's known for. She's got the safest hands in the business normally.
I think she's a bit excited by the colour of this tournament, Ash Braz.
About a distraction.
Stoles and Road there in the circle. Pullman trying her best. Just some of the defensive positioning. Here's Stoles.
Whole time. Goal defence, that's intimidation again. That's now a warning.
Oh, interesting call.
Kate Shimmett. Who cares? It doesn't matter. Renski Stoles just says, get on with it. Get on with it. So a big three for the youngster.
I've got Liz Ellis in my head, which is never a good thing, but her saying a defender's job is to intimidate. It's an interesting call, isn't it?
And you're right, Liz Ellis in your head. That's bad news.
Not a good day at the office.
Not at all. So 1 minute now left on the clock. And don't forget, for $10,000, your netball club could have, by simply putting the code word SuperShot on that little web address down there, facebook.com/9netball, $10,000, you could be richer for your netball club. Get into it. So 31-18 the score, a wayward pass. Tegan Phillip can't bring that in. And the heat now right out of this game, isn't it? It doesn't matter. Stoll says, I'll just see if I can be a superstar. Kate Shimmett, well, nearly a deflection, but it's the obstruction call.
Shortening your distance.
So Pullman will defend this shot. She won't worry about the offload. Stoles goes high. Now you're down, Melbourne. Let's go, Aussies. Let's go. And the final run to the post for Australia here. Game 13. And their last game before finals. Let's go, Aussies. Let's go. Hadley, Tegan Phillip to shoot on the siren. not to be, but it won't really matter because Australia have come away convincingly against South Africa with a 31-18 scoreline. And they will now be able to rest up before finals. We'll have to wait and see just who it is playing off for our gold, silver and bronze medals. And we know that England and Jamaica are looking very, very good, but there's still a couple of games to come. Kath, thoughts on that one?
Australia, what a use of the power play. 20 points in contrast, as I mentioned, South Africa just the six, so the power play is just so important.
So the fans very happy to see the Aussies walking off the court victorious. And Gretel Tippett there, just arms around Ash Braz. Two superstars, but G Tippett's stepped up so far. Let's get down to Ann Sargent. She's got Sam Pullman with her.
Thanks, Sue. Well, Sam, congratulations. Solid performance from Australia. Build off the back of some great defence. You laid the platform against South Africa's power play.
Yeah, we wanted to be consistent with what we were doing, and I think we let that slip during England. So we really needed to take advantage of their power play and then shut it down in the last quarter.
That looks like you might have shaped up for a touch of a bronze medal, and it may well be a trans-Tasman rivalry again. How do you feel about that?
Yeah, I think every game here has been really intense, really fast, and hopefully something the crowd is really getting behind. So, yeah, we'll prepare, ready to take on who we do.
Good luck. We look forward to more of the same.
Thanks, Annie.
So there you have it. The Aussies looking good at the moment in their gold. A good win against South Africa. Don't go anywhere because we've still got more fun to have. New Zealand and Malawi, and then the celebrity game right here on Nine's Wide World of Sports.